This is our third year in a row we've been growing the shrimp.
If jumbo shrimp is the classic oxymoron, then Midwestern shrimp can't be far behind. But University of New Hampshire scientist Michael Chambers is developing an aquaculture system that will grow shrimp virtually anywhere.
In a controlled environment, the shrimp grow close to 1.5 grams per week. So we can take this tiny little shrimp, and in 4 months, we can have it about 20 grams, which you can take to a local market.
The secret is in this brown, turbid water known as BioFlock.
It's kind of like a brown living water. It's a living filter of sorts.
It provides protein-rich nutrients on which the shrimp feed, and it also recycles their waste products.
What we look for is the brown digestive tract. Mm-hmm. That shows us that they're eating well, it's full, and we're optimizing the system and their growth rates.
Chambers sees this as a viable crop for fishermen during their off seasons and for farmers anywhere in the country. Already, it's being used by scores of farmers in the Midwest.
These are mostly small swimming pools in their basements or a barn, and they could have 6 to maybe 12, and they're generating between $40,000 to $60,000 income on the side.
Chambers and his team help startups with tank design and BioFlock composition. As for the final product, Chambers says the shrimp are far superior to the frozen variety most of us are accustomed to.
The processed shrimp doesn't have as much flavor. It tastes a little watered down, where these don't. It's a richer, deeper flavor, just much better.
A better understanding of bridges is the goal of another University of New Hampshire project known as the Living Bridge. The recently built Memorial Bridge connecting Portsmouth and Kittery is outfitted with a variety of sophisticated sensors. Aaron Bell is a UNH engineering professor.
We developed this idea of the Living Bridge. A bridge like this that has pedestrian access, community engagement, could do much more than get you from A to B, could educate you, could show you about renewable energy and tidal power, and could also advance the state of bridge design.
Sensors on the bridge monitor stress, loads, traffic, and environmental factors like wind and humidity. And there's plenty of good data, especially from the vertical lift.
Because this lifts so often, we get what would be akin to a stress test every half an hour, all summer long. And so I get a nice big impact and I can watch what happens to the bridge or how the bridge responds. And we can use that to characterize its performance.
The information helps verify and refine computer modeling and will influence future bridge design. Below the bridge is a platform that gathers data on the estuary, like salinity, temperature, and turbidity of the water. It also has a recently installed turbine testing the viability of using tidal currents to generate electricity. Ian Gagneau is a graduate student finishing his thesis.
We're learning about how can we deploy tidal turbines at bridges, and in the future, possibly someone will build a bridge with tidal turbines kind of built into it from the onset. And that's when you really could potentially make a lot of energy.
The data is used in undergraduate and graduate classes at UNH and is also used as a teaching tool in local middle and high schools. And Aaron Bell believes the Living Bridge can make connections beyond just joining New Hampshire and Maine.
That's how you get the next generation of engineers, is not talking to them about you should want to do math and science. It's you get to do things that make this a better place to live. Have bridges like this, have clean energy, learn about them and advance them. And that's, I think, how you inspire young engineers. You can actually help people and make the world a better place.